Adam Hill's with me on Skype this morning from Oncimmune. Adam, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. Look, we spoke a bit earlier this week on that important Biodesix deal. Now news this morning of an agreement with Russia's leading drug maker. Tell me a bit more.
Yeah, thank you very much. It's been particularly busy. The second deal done yesterday to commercialize our early CDT lung product in screening with the Russian drug giant R-Pharm.
Why is Russia an important market?
So Russia has about 38 million smokers and 60,000 lung cancer diagnoses each year, with about 55,000 deaths attributed to lung cancer on an annual basis. So whilst not the largest market by population, certainly the demographic makes it a very attractive screening opportunity for Oncimmune. And on the back of the ECLS result, of which we released the top line summary maybe 6 weeks ago now, R-Pharm are very keen to use the early CDT lung product in initiating those screening programs, starting with Moscow and then building out across the rest of Russia.
And am I right in thinking it's not just Russia? There's the option to take the test to other nearby countries as well?
Yeah, that's right. And so there is a federation of countries associated with the Russian opportunity in which R-Pharm has a significant footprint, and they have the option to also commercialize the product and for screening in those territories.
So how valuable is this deal to you? What's it worth?
So this over the initial term, which is 5 years, is worth about £5 million to us. 2.75 million are linked to cash-based milestone payments for increasing size of screening program from health system-wide to city-wide to eventually nationwide screening. So approximately 50% of the deal is attributed to volume-based minima over the initial term.
And R-Pharm, they'll be funding the infrastructure, will they, to allow the screening to take place?
That's right. You'll appreciate that it's not just a case of knocking on the door of the health system that's required to drive a screening program into a country such as Russia. And so R-Pharm are gearing up to make a considerable investment in the infrastructure required to market and to sell and then deliver the product into the health system at volume.
And as you said right at the start, that you're gaining some momentum when it comes to these deals. Do you feel as though it's a validation, if you like, of the commercial strategy?
It's absolutely a validation of the commercial strategy we launched in October last year, where we said that we would be going to market with our critical assets through partnership. But more importantly, it's a validation of the top line data that we got from the ECLS study only six weeks ago. And whilst that the full data set is yet to be published, and we expect to see that and it be available for investors at the back end of the summer. There is, of course, demonstrated by these two deals, commercial traction ahead of release of the full data package.
Good to see you, Adam. Thanks for the update this morning.
Thanks for your time.